So glad you guys are here on this foggy Sunday. Welcome. Today we're going to learn about strength and gifts and a story related to that. So have you guys ever thought about the word just? Do you know what the word just means? It means what's good and right. And we're going to learn about how God is a just God, and He does what is good and right all the time. So let's stand up and sing our first song.
Yeah, yeah, we shine, the light of God. And when we speak with the words of love. And when we dance, we make it a little wild. 'Cause we're the people of God, yeah, the people of God, yeah.
That God gives us. So believe it or not, everybody is given a gift. We all have a unique gift that is given to us by God. And sometimes part of life is figuring out what that gift is. Some of you already know it's pretty clear. You might be a good artist. You might be really fond of animals. Whatever that gift is, we all have something that we can do to glorify God, because that's the purpose of our gifts. Is to glorify God, right? So, let's sing our next song.
Yeah,
purpose, you had a plan. You hold my future in your hands, and I believe it's true. You reached out and you rescued me. You gave me love for the world to see.
I wanted to go over the D6 and remind you guys about that. Is Ruth Kappen in here this morning by chance? No? She might be a second service person. Oh, there she is. She has completed her D6, so she gets to pick something out of the prize box. And just a reminder, if you guys want to do these, it's a great way to earn a prize and also get money towards church events. So you can get these online. Make sure you do that. And directions are on it. You can follow it, and it'll encourage you in your walk with God as well, which, of course, is the ultimate goal. So.
All right. Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome to another Sunday morning here in Kids at Magnify, and welcome to anyone who may be joining us online. And we have kind of moved into a new phase of our Bible stories, which is kind of fun. We are learning from the book of Judges. And last week, what's the name of the guy that we learned about? Gideon, all right? And Gideon, did he start off as, like, really strong, really brave, really psyched up to get out there and fight the Midianites? No? No, he was scared, but God helped him defeat the Midianites. Okay, and today we're going to learn about another judge. Okay, but one of the unfortunate things about the book of Judges is that it shows us a cycle in the Israelites' lives. Just like every year we have spring, summer, winter, or fall and winter, the Israelites went through cycles in their lives that caused them to need help from God. So here's how this worked, okay? So last week, we learned about how, can you see that little blue circle up there-ish? Kind of. There it is. All right. So last week we learned the Israelites, they sinned, okay? And then because of their sin, because they broke God's law, that caused them to be oppressed. God let another group of people from outside of Israel come and take things over, and they would hurt the Israelites and steal their grain and pillage their houses and all kinds of bad stuff. And the Israelites would realize what they'd done wrong, and they would cry out to God and say, God, please help us, send somebody to save us from these terrible people. All right, send someone to help us. And so God would listen to their prayer. He would hear their repentance, and he would listen to them. And he would send someone to deliver them. And last week, the person that we learned about who delivered them was Gideon. All right, and God had that really fancy process for them to use to defeat the enemies. And people weren't quite sure what was going to happen, but God had a plan for it. And then after the judge rescues them, there is peace for a generation or two, but eventually the Israelites will fall back into sin, and the whole cycle will repeat over and over and over again. All right, so that's where our story picks up today, is that there was a couple decades of peace, a couple generations of peace with the Israelites, but they've fallen back into sin, and they're going to need a new judge to rescue them from the Philistines. The Philistines. Okay? So that's where we're going to pick up today, with a guy named Samson. Here we go.
Alright. So like Will said, they were being oppressed, and so then they were asking for help. So I'm really excited to be here today to go over your story together with you. And I think the thing we want to start with always is the Bible, but just the fact that God always hears our prayers. And in order to do that, though, to see how God answered these the prayers of the Israelites, we're going to look at the Bible, and this comes from the book of Judges, chapter 13. So I'm going to read a little bit here, and then we're going to get into this part on Samson. And the people of Israel again did what was evil in the sight of the Lord. So the Lord gave them into the hands of the Philistines for 40 years. 40 years. How old are you guys right now? 9, 10. All right. So, like, four times. All right, I don't need to hear everybody's age. I got it. All right. 40 years. So if you're 10, 40 feels like a long time. Now, there was a certain man of Zorah of the tribe of the Danites whose name was Manoah, and his wife was barren and had no children. And the angel of the Lord appeared to the woman and said to her, behold, you are barren and have not borne children, but you will conceive and bear a son. Therefore be careful and drink no wine or strong drink and eat nothing unclean. For behold, you will conceive and bear a son. No razor shall come to his head, for the child shall be a Nazarite to God from the womb. And he shall begin to save Israel from the hand of the Philistines. The woman came and told her husband, a man of God came to me, and his appearance was like that of an angel of God, very awesome. I did not ask him where he came from, but he did tell me this, his name. He said to me, behold, you shall conceive and bear a son. So then drink no wine or strong drink and eat nothing unclean, for the child to be a Nazarite to God from the womb, from the day of his birth. And I'm also going to read you one more verse here. And the woman bore a son and called his name Samson, and the young man grew, and the Lord blessed him. Okay, so we already knew the Philistines were the people that were there, and we know that God often works in different and mysterious ways. And this is the theme you're going to hear over and over and over from this story about all these weird different things that maybe we didn't predict, but these were ways that God intervened. I want to make sure this is on. I don't see any lights on it, but okay, good. So my job right now is to kind of give you a little bit of background info on Samson, but I think the best way for me to do this would be for you guys to tell me what you know about Samson. So who's heard about Samson before? Couple people. All right, so give me like two or three facts. You don't have to give me everything, but two or three things about Samson.
He has really long hair, and he ripped down the walls.
Okay, really long hair, ripped down the walls. So we got a couple things. Two new things to add.
He's really strong.
Okay, anything else? Okay, really long hair, ripped down the walls, really strong. I see two hands. We're going to go one here and one here. Go ahead. What do you have to add?
As long as he didn't cut his hair, he would always be strong.
Okay, as long as he didn't cut his hair, that was going to be yours right there? All right. Anyone else have any new info about Samson to add? Okay, we're going to grab one fact about Samson. Go ahead.
That Samson was
All right, so there's going to be temptation to do things. So yes, we're going to get to that. Last one.
Couldn't touch dead animals.
Oh, that would make someone unclean. So that would be a bad thing as someone who was a Nazirite. Okay, you guys got the background here on Samson, probably what we need to know. And so we will get into the story. The angel of the Lord told Samson's parents that their son was to be God's Nazirite from birth. Can you imagine if you never cut your hair? Like for me, my hair would probably still be the same. This handsome-looking Israelite probably would be the same as well. But how long do you guys think your hair would be if it never got cut? Long. Some of us old people have been along for more than 10 years. Maybe they'd be on the ground. Who knows? But that was one of the things. So I know I got lots of conversations going. Got to bring you guys back here because I want you guys to hear the story. You will have some time to talk to your friends in a second. And I'll know you're paying attention if I don't hear you guys talking and you're looking here at me. All right. So Samson grew and God blessed him. One day. All right. He grew and God blessed him. One day when he was old enough to get married, he fell in love with a Philistine woman.
Mother, father, I have found a Philistine woman who is very beautiful, and I would like to make her my wife.
Now hold up here. The Philistines were what? Evil. Were they our friends? No, they were the enemy. So this was a huge shock to the parents. So he wanted to marry him, and it was very confusing, and his parents were confused as well. They had no idea that God was behind this. And again, remember, today, all the time, God works in all kinds of ways. Sometimes it makes sense. Sometimes it's confusing. The story today is going to give you time after time after time where it's like, what's going on here? It didn't make sense. So the parents had no idea, but God was still at work behind this. God was going to give Samson a reason to fight the Philistines. And this was going to be one of the ways that God used his power to allow them to get free from the Philistines. So, Samson took his parents to meet this Philistine woman. And so they went on a little bit of a journey. Let me break this down for you in case you're wondering what happened, okay? A young lion came roaring. And at this time, I just want you guys to think about this. The Spirit of God came on Samson and gave him great strength. Now, as Christians today, when we accept Jesus as our Savior, the Holy Spirit comes in and fills us. We'll get comments in a second. But back then, before Jesus died on the cross, people didn't have that. God, at different times throughout different stories, you hear about how God came and his spirit came on to someone. And in this instance, it came on Samson's and gave him power to fight off the lion with his bare hands. So, unexpected, right? So, unexpected, going to marry this Philistine. Unexpected what happens here. Well, Samson decides not to tell his parents he killed the lion, but he wanted to catch up on with them because he wanted to introduce them to the woman he wanted to marry. All right, so they obviously meet, he introduces them, and a few days later, he decided to go for a walk by himself into the woods to see whatever happened to that lion that he killed. And when he got there, there was a swarm of bees in the lion's carcass. Was this a live animal? Oh, we learned something, like he's not supposed to touch dead animals, but he saw inside there a swarm of bees, and he scooped up the honey with his hands and ate some, and he brought them then, the rest back over to his parents. And he went over there and to the Philistine country so he could get married. And weddings in those days lasted days and sometimes weeks. And at one point during this wedding feast, he decided to tell the Philistine men a riddle. Out of the eater came something to eat. Out of the strong came something sweet. And I want you guys to talk about what might this riddle be. what's the riddle? Anyone got it for us? What is out of the eater came something to eat? What are they talking about right now? The lion. Yes, and then out of the straw came something sweet they're talking about? The honey. Okay, so our story continues. We figured it out, but guess what? The Philistines didn't know about this. They didn't have a honey stick. They had no idea. They were stumped, and they didn't want to lose to Samson, their enemy, so they went and threatened Samson's bride to try to get the answer to the riddle for themselves.
Get us the answer, or else.
They told the woman they would harm her and her family if she didn't get them to answer the answer to the riddle. So the woman went pleading to her husband.
You don't even love me. You must hate me. You've told my people a riddle, and you won't even tell me the answer.
What are you talking about? Not even my own parents know the answer.
All right, so the bride, I mean, imagine where she's in the position. She's going to be killed. Her family's going to be killed if she can't get this answer. So she starts to beg and try to get information on this, on the answer. So I want you guys all, and this went on for 7 days. So you guys got to work with me, right? I need you guys all to step up real quick, stand up real quick. We are going to beg for 7 days, but we're just going to basically start with Monday. And I need you guys to make your first begging pose, like make a begging pose, and we're gonna whine. We're gonna say Monday. Like, you guys ready? Monday. All right, new pose. It's Tuesday. Tuesday. New pose, everybody. Maybe get on your knees. Wednesday. Let's beg. Thursday, please. Friday. Saturday. Sunday. Okay, that's exhausting. Have a seat. That was exhausting for us, but imagine what it was like for the two of them. Finally, Samson was so worn down, he told her the answer to the riddle.
All right. What is sweeter than honey? What is stronger than a lion?
All right, so she ran off to share that information, and Samson found out. And he got really, really mad. So I want you guys to make a really mad face. All right, here we go. Mad face. Samson, let's see your mad face. All right. It gets worse. He loved this woman, and she betrayed his trust. They also then took his wife and gave them to someone else to marry. Super angry. Samson is just furious.
I'm going to get back to those Philistines for good.
All right, so he went stomping off angry and mad. Now, this is a story of unexpected things. Samson went and married the enemy. He then lost his temper, and guess what? God gave him power. The Spirit of God came powerfully on Samson. And after marrying the enemy, Samson went out and caught 300 foxes, tied them together, and we'll tell you more about what he did there, but we're going to have you guys talk first. So he went out and he got 300 foxes. So here's the questions for you guys to have in a turn and talk. How do you think he got them? Where do you think he put them after he tied them together? And do you think he got bit? Question number 3, and I will give you the definitive answer when we're done. I'm sure everyone wants to know. How many people here think that Samson got bit?
No.
All right. How many people here think Samson did not get bit? All right. The definitive answer is we don't know. The Bible didn't tell us. So that's the definitive answer. Hopefully you got some ideas on how he caught the foxes. We don't know all that either. We do know what happened to them afterwards. So we're going to show you a little video, and we're going to talk this through. So Samson went out, like we know, and he caught 300 foxes. What we know about this is that he tied them together in pairs by their tails, and he put a torch in between them and set them on fire, or set the torch on fire. Important. Based on what you can see from the video, what did Samson do once he lit the torches on fire? Where'd he send them? He sent them out into the Philistines' fields. So this was his way of burning down all their fields. And so he went and got back at them. And if you had a field and it was burned down by grain, you probably would get pretty mad. But also we know that Samson killed many Philistines that day, and after that, Samson went on and stayed in a cave. So he went, after going out and burning down the fields and being angry and killing a bunch of people, he went over to a cave. Now, the Philistines were pretty happy. No, they were pretty upset. So they started attacking the Israelites, and they said they would not stop until the Israelite people brought them Samson. So they had 3,000 people from the tribe of Judah. And remember, Judah is with what country? Israel or Philistine? Israel. And Samson is a Israelite. So 3,000 Israelites went to an Israelite to get him and to bring him to the Philistines. Again, this doesn't make sense. But again, God can work in mysterious ways. And we learned that a lot in this story here in Samson.
Hey, Samson, we're here to take you to the Philistines.
Fine, as long as you promise not to hurt me.
Yeah, yeah, we'll take you over there, but we won't kill you. Let's go.
All right. So, he allowed himself to be bound up with new rope, and they got him all nice and tight, and they started bringing him over to the Philistines, and the Philistines came out shouting, and they were shouting, capture him. So I need you guys to shout with me, right? Ready? Capture him! Capture him! Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Samson. And again, mysterious and unexpected, the rope snapped like they were pieces of thread. All right. So, now, after these ropes broke off, Samson then fought. How many men were there all together? 3,000 Israelites, we don't know how many Philistines, but we know that he went on and killed a bunch of Philistines, 1,000 men, with just the jawbone of a donkey. So a dead donkey, he had a bone there, and he killed 1,000 men. When he was finished, what do you guys think, how do you think Samson would be feeling after killing 1,000 men? Victorious, yep. Hot and thirsty. So here's what happened. Again, very, very mysterious. Samson was prayed to God for some water, and God split open a rock, and water came out and gushed to provide water for Samson. So again, mysterious, the way God provided. Again, a rock isn't really known for wetness inside, but God provided for him. So again, this story has so many incredible things. There's no way Samson could have done the things he did without God giving him the strength and power. After Samson defeated the Philistines, he went on to be the judge of Israel for 20 years. But But then, one day, he met another beautiful Philistine woman. Her name was Delilah. She had many, many boyfriends and wasn't trustworthy. Even though she was an enemy with a bad reputation, guess what Samson did? He fell in love with her. I know. Come on, Samson. What is going on? So, now there was no riddle here, but let's think this through, guys. Do you think the Philistines all of a sudden were like, hey, that's cool. I need everyone's attention here. There is a lot of drama in this story. A lot of drama, a lot of twists and turns. So part of the drama here is, do you think all the other Philistines were like, oh, he's cool now. It doesn't matter. He's killed thousands of our people. Or how do you think the Philistines feel about Samson right now? Yeah, they're not good. They're not good at all. So what happened is some men came and they went to Delilah and they said, hey, you need to tell us what we need to do, where his power comes from. You need to make sure that you can tell us where his strengths come from. And they also threatened and also rewarded and said, if you do this, we're going to give you lots of money. And she said, okay. So she asked him, and guess what? He didn't tell her right off the bat. So guess what she had to do? You got it. She had to beg and plead. So we're going to go a little bit sooner, faster through, but I need everybody back up again. We're going to do our Monday to Sunday, but it's going to be like every 2 seconds, so we're going to need to do lots of poses, okay? You guys ready with me for Monday? Let me hear just ahead of time. What's your whiny Monday voice? Let's hear it. Whinier. Okay, you guys ready? All right. Monday! Tuesday! Wednesday! Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then guess what? Eventually, it worked because he told her the secret.
Fine. A razor has never touched my head. My hair has never been cut. I've never done anything like that. That's why it's just long and luscious.
All right, so exhausted that he fell asleep, like just tired. She ran off and she told, and let's find out what she told people.
His hair has never been cut. I will go cut it and then I'll come get you. Go get him.
So the Philistines seized him and his teddy lion, and they got him and they gouged out his eyes, and they put him in shackles, and they put him in prison, and they kept him in prison for a long, long time. It was years and years and years, but then eventually they were having a big party. So there we go. We got the dance move party going on there. I don't know if they were dancing or not. They had a big party, and they wanted to bring him out, and they wanted to basically show him off. And so they brought him out, and they put him in between two pillars there so everyone could see him. So it's like center stage, so the whole audience could see this person who used to torment them, but now was blind and their prisoner. Now, Samson did pray out to God.
God, even though they took my eyes, let me fight these Philistines one more time.
So he asked for power from God, and Samson put his hands on the two center pillars that held the tower of the whole temple, and he prayed.
Let me die with the Philistines!
Ah! All right. So, yes, well done. So, why don't you guys come up, take a bow. Come on up, take a bow. That was fantastic. I'll get out of the way. I don't deserve a bow. All right. And exit stage right. Well done. All right. And based on the video recording we have, Based on the video recording we had from the Bible, that's exactly how it happened. And yes, that's a joke. There was no video recording, just in case you're... Okay, all right. The temple crashed down around the Philistine rulers and the people. And on that day, and again, we had told you all about the times we had killed Philistines. I need you guys' attention. We're almost there. We're almost there. Again, I know of your attention if you're looking at me and if you're not talking to anybody. On that day, he killed more Philistines than he did the rest of his entire life. Again, another surprise ending. Samson died with the Philistines. God had given him great strength to do the things he did. And God worked in that whole story in all kinds of mysterious, unexpected ways. And he still does that today. Our God is amazing because he can accomplish his plans in ways that make sense to us, but also in mysterious ways and unexpected ways. So we're going to go ahead and bring up the red thread verse, and we're going to kind of talk this through, and then we're going to pray. So, you guys know the story, right? Before we do this, I want to say a few things. Number one, I'll get everyone's attention here. So in this story, God worked in all kinds of mysterious ways, in unexpected ways. You know what else is unexpected? It's the fact that God created you and me, and he has a plan for our lives, just like he had a plan for Samson's life. Hopefully a little bit less drama, but who knows? He loves you and wants to be with you forever. Jesus rescues us from our sins so we can be with him forever. And remember this, and remember to share this news with others. So together we're going to read this, okay? For unto us a child is born, just a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. All right, we're going to pray real quick, okay? Let me get your attention so we can pray. All right. You guys can stop fighting for just a second. We can worry about the rope in a minute. You guys ready? All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this church. Thank you for the chance for us to come together. Lord, just thank you for the stories of what you have done. It reminds us, it teaches us of who you are, and reminds us that you are faithful. Lord, thank you for the story of Samson. You do work in mysterious ways. If someone were to look and were to have written out the story the way that they thought it should go based on, you know, being an Israelite and how they wanted to defeat the Philistines, it would have looked very different. But you still got your purpose done in ways that you desired. So help us remember that you love us, that you care for us, and that you're powerful. And even when things don't always make sense, just for us to remember that you are always in charge. Pray for a blessing on the rest of this day. In your name, amen.